Well, it's better than nothing, Pearson.
Well, I'll take what I can get. Many thanks, Mr. Morgan.
Hi there, folks. Good morning, Arthur.
Hi.
Hey there. That's my boy.
Hi there.
Gentlemen. Hey, Strauss.
Arthur.
Don't forget about me. I'm starving. Have a lovely meal, folks. Please don't hurt me.
Not you again. Come on, you can do better than that.
Hello?
Hey. You're looking good?
Thank you.
Back at it, boy.
Thank you.
Shit. Yep, yep. Come on. You're all right, boy. Hold on.
Yep.
Or a siphon.
Here, drink this.
Medicine? Oh, thank you, Jesus. You saved my life. I owe you.
Got that right.
I do. Now, I gotta get out of here. Don't much like it around here no more.
Glad I could help. Keep your eyes on the ground, huh? go. Okay, boy.
You. What did I tell you? Get the hell out of here!
Eagle got this bridge, feller.
You best clear off.
Hold up.
Hey, mister.
We got a long way to go, huh? I asked my boys here if they would help their pa build a new house. Thought I'd teach them a few things, you know. Couldn't hammer a nail to save their lives. Ain't that right, Curtis?
Whatever you say, pa.
Look out!
What in holy hell are you doing, boy? Get that back up again right now. I'm gonna be 100 years old by the time we get this done. No. Get away from it. Get away from it before you mess it up even worse than it is.
All the best.
You too, friend.
Why does he yell at us like that? He don't like the way we're doing it. He should do it himself. Damn straight.
Let's just enjoy the silence for a few minutes before he starts griping at us again.
You boys don't seem cut out for this.
Oh, I agree. We ain't. This is our pa's dumb idea.
Who let the simpleton out of the asylum?
Hey, what did I do?
Just exactly how dumb are you?
Just leave me be! Hey, help me! No, don't shoot!
Stay away from me!
Here.
Looking to see a show?
I need a ticket, please.
Okay, head on in. Tent to your left.
Tell you a morality tale from when our country was young, that the settlers used to tell about the woods of Massachusetts and the creatures that lived there. One summer, a bear was by the stream, and Old Man Wind appeared and said, "Bear, I shall blow a mighty cold upon the land. Engorge yourself on fish and meat and go find a den. Then sleep, not for one night, but for 60. Go tell all the animals of the forest what I have told you." Bear was sad because the fish were his friends, and now he had to eat them. But he knew to do whatever the wind told him. The animals of the forest often teased Bear and said he was slow and lazy and foolish for listening to Old Man Wind. "You're talking to the wind again, eh?" laughed the rabbit. "I think Bear has finally taken leave of his senses," said the turtle, "and he's getting so rotund that even I could outrun him." "I'm smart and quick," said Rabbit. "I'll outrun Old Man Wind if he comes a-calling, or you, since you're into eating your friends." The turtle said, "If Wind comes, I'll just hide in my shell." Then Bear went and warned Coyote and Possum that they should prepare for a long, cold winter. "It's so hot," said the coyote. "There's plenty of time." The lazy possum said, "Well, there's an abundance of food. Maybe I'll just store some in my pouch." Even his squirrel friends made fun of Bear. They laughed and laughed and squibbled and squabbled. "Chunky needs a nap. Fatty Goody Two Shoes does what he's told." Bear was very sad, but he was a good bear, and he always did what Old Man Wind told him. He went and found a den, snuggled inside, and fell fast asleep. Bear snored and snored for many days. Up, he saw spring had come. He was very hungry, so he walked outside. As the snow melted, he saw all his friends who hadn't listened, frozen and just ready to be eaten. And that's why the bear hibernates. So listen to your elders and do just what you're told.
Hope to see you again.
Madam, back here.
Morning, mister.
Hi there, mister. Hey, partner.
Come on, try and help people. I do all I can manage. Are you doing all you can? Huh? Use your strength to help the weak. How about you, sir?
Hello, mister. You get a lot of money doing this?
Not much. But it's the trying that counts.
If you say so.
Well, I do. And who do you help?
I'll help you learn to keep your mouth closed.
Sorry, sir. Come on, please. Please, somebody, be generous. Show you care. Come on, please, somebody.
I tell you, this place is cursed.
Boy.
Give more. Please. Prove we ain't a land of savages. Prove we're here for each other.
Good morning.
Yeah. It is in giving that we receive the true gifts of life that are eternal. So give generously, for that is what this country needs, to help each other.
Hey, all right, there we go. Oh, Arthur! Arthur, come here. Come over here. I want you to meet our friends.
Pleased to meet you.
Well, ain't you just the toughest teak mountain man?
Oh, you be quiet, Anastasia. Anyone can tell this one is a pussy cat.
Exactly. Yes, he's a pussy cat. Ain't that so, Arthur?
Whatever you say. How much you cost, anyway?
Well, ain't that a nice way to talk to a lady?
Oh, I didn't know I was talking to a lady.
Excuse me.
Well, I must say, you got a fine way with the women, amigo.
Yeah, regular dandy and a charmer. Where's Bill?
Oh, man, I dread to think about it.
Hey.
There
he is.
Watch where you're going.
Take it easy, pal.
Are you about to kiss that guy or punch him?
Oh, and we have our answer.
Come here, you.
Let's just kick these bastards.
Okay.
Let's go, Arthur!
in the mud.
I beg you, stop. Come, sir. You won the fight already. Surely that's enough.
What business is it of yours?
No business. No business, sir, but please, I beg you.
Making new friends again, I see, Arthur.
Look who we found sniffing about.
Josiah Trelawney.
The very same.
Well, I thought you'd gone to New York.
And miss all this glamour. You must be joking.
How are you?
Well, quite well indeed. I went to Blackwater looking for you gentlemen. You're not very popular there, it seems. Ah, Javier and Charles. I've missed you. And Bill, looking as well as can be. Gentlemen, always a pleasure.
You're right. We ain't too popular in Blackwater.
We left a lot of money there.
And young Sean, it seems.
Sean, you found him?
Yes, I have. He's being held by some bounty hunters, trying to see how much money the government will pay them. I know he's in Blackwater, but there's talk of them moving.
Well, if we step foot in Blackwater, well, then we're dead men for sure.
There'll be Pinkertons all over the place, but if he's alive, we gotta try.
Yeah, of course.
It's you they want, Dutch.
Always is. Charles, go find out what you can, carefully. Josiah, take Javier. Arthur, go get yourself cleaned up. Join them when you're ready.
Well, what about me?
Well, exactly. What about you?
What does that mean?
Oh, Bill, come on.
Hey, Sheriff.
Morning, son.
Morning, partner.
Give a fella a nickel. Give me a dime. Oh, God.
Excuse me, partner.
I knew that.
Hey, mister.
Hey there.
I want to get a drink. I'm parched.
Howdy.
You better have left your troublemaking way behind.
Give a fellow a nickel.
Come on.
Watch it!
Didn't mean nothing by it.
Ain't nobody got a heart.
I'll take care of bartender.
Come on, sir. Try to remember what really happened at Sylvia's Saloon back in 70s.
Just a lot of bunk, Plato. It's just a lot of bunk.
It's not bunk, Mr. Calloway, sir.
Who's your friend there?
Put that in your fucking book, Plato.
This is Jim Boy Calloway. The Jim Boy Calloway.
Who?
The gunslinger. Fastest left-handed draw that ever drew breath. He once killed 14 men in a fight at Lucy Hollow.
What are you waiting for?
How do you mean?
Well, I reckon right now, kill him yourself.
I don't want to kill him. I want to deify him. He's a god. I'm trying to write his biography.
How's that going?
I think I prefer the duel. Either I'd kill him and be able to be Baltimore's finest ever gunslinger, or he'd kill me, and I could be set free from ever having to speak to him again.
Well, you're starting to understand something very important.
What's that?
The joys of gunslinging. It's win-win, freedom or glory.
That's brilliant. I'm gonna write that down, if I may.
Be my guest.
What's your name?
I don't have a name.
But you are a gunslinger.
Not really. I mean, folks who need shooting, I try and shoot in the back. All that other stuff, it's, well, bunk.
But you fought duels.
Once upon a time, I may have.
And you ain't interested in fame?
I don't think so.
Strange. But you like fortune.
I need money, sure.
Okay. Then forgive me, mister, if I seem a little desperate. I am a little desperate. This book, I've got to make a thing of it, and, well, there's a whole list of gunfighters. Legends, every last one. Emmett Granger. Flacco Hernandez. Billy Midnight. Black Bell.
Never heard of them.
Maybe you can go and speak to them. Ask them about Calloway. Any of them get uppity, shoot him. I can't believe I just said that, but...
You want me to go and find some sad, deluded fools like him, ask if he was the greatest, and then if they get uppity, shoot him?
Does sound a lot worse than it did in my head.
How much you paying?
Well, a lot. Half the proceeds of the book, if you help me get it written.
I'll see what I can do.
Ha! Oh, get photos.
Okay.
And there are notes on the back of those portraits that should lead you to him.
I'll see what I can find out.
I imagine we'll be stuck here upon your return. Here are some other flop house.
You got a problem?
Ooh. Oh, you poor bastard.
Yep, yep. Wait.
Just give me a minute, boy.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hey there, mister.
Damn good shooting, señor. Thank God for you, mister. Le debo la vida.
Good luck with it.
Qué alivio.
Hold on. Come on, boy.
Looks like you're just learning how to hunt those kills.
It ain't a competition, friend. Easy.
Your blood.
Easy.
This way. Come on.
So move on. You get your ass out of here.
All right.
Jesus, anyone, help! Guess you forgot you was yelling. Help! Don't do this. You
now,
shit bastard.
I'm gonna check your pockets.
Well, been a pleasure.